Hi, can you hear us?
Okay, I think everything is clear and we can start. Welcome everybody to the second webinar of Universal. In this webinar, we are going to look at the Universal Reference Model. My name is Konstantin Kersten. I'm from Prosus Software, and I'm joined today by my colleague, Wendelin Arnaudo. If you want to know what Universal is about and did not see the first webinar, I would encourage you to have a look at it, because there we talk about everything which is needed to understand how the Universal project came to be and all the different projects it emerged from. In this webinar, we will show a little video just to get to know Universal a little bit. And then Wendelin is going to present the reference model of Universal. And after that, we're going to have a discussion. Okay. And I think without more words, we're going to start the video.
Sometimes elderly people had a bad experience and need help in their daily life. Most of the time they ask their neighbors, friends, or relatives for help. The U-Store and one-stop shop of Universal provides solutions for elderly needs. Also, the service providers and developers who are specialized in the AAL domain can develop new applications and devices, receive requests directly from the end users, and merchandise their services, products, and applications. The online developer handbook consists of the basics about how to use the Universal platform. The available developer tools at the tools wiki pages instruct the user with the installation process of the AAL Studio, an integrated development environment based on Eclipse for building applications and components using the Universal execution platform. The AAL Studio will make it easier to start the development and will make the development process more efficient. The Open AAL Studio dashboard allows the developer controlling the whole development cycle easily. When the service provider decides to offer the new application as a service to the entire community, he logs into the management center and offers it for sale in the U-Store. In this way, every needs and requirements dealing with AAL can be satisfied. The Universal platform provides solution for everyone and brings them together: the developer, the service provider, and the end user.
So that is the video. I think you got a good introduction into Universal. And as I said before, the webinar is going to be online on the website, and you can check the first video if you want to have more detailed information about how it's going to be and so on. And now I'm handing over to my colleague, Wendelin Arnaudo. He's going to do the presentation of the reference model. And keep in mind, after that, you can have a discussion on points you want to have explained more clearly, or general questions as well. Okay.
Hi, I'm going to specification of universal reference model. Just a short overview, as you probably know from the first video, but for the people that are just starting from this webinar, the universal is aiming to provide the technological platform that is open and scalable and facilitates the services, their development, deployment, in order to provide some help to elderly and assisted persons. Of course, the goal of the project is to provide widespread acceptance and adoption of this platform. You have seen from the video the three different universal platforms: the developer depot with the EO Studio. These are development tools that assist the developers in modeling, developing, testing, and uploading, sharing their components. We have the application store, it's the EU store, of course it comes from Universal, where the software applications are uploaded, the ones that the developer wants to deliver to the assisted persons. There, the service providers are able to select out of the applications in the repository and build an AO service that consists of this application, possible sensors, devices, and human resources, some care personnel. All this is provided on the EU store for the end users, and the end user or the relatives that represent them can acquire, purchase, and order such services. Then they are deployed, the software is installed on runtime platform, hardware is delivered and configured there. The care personnel is introduced to the elderly person or assisted person, as we have it, or more generic. And then the realization consumption of the service can start. So we try to specify these platforms, and we do this in three levels of abstraction. The first is the reference model that gives the overall understanding of the relationships between the entities in this environment. It defines concepts, axioms, relationship within some specific problem domain. Then we have some more specific level. This is the reference architecture that abstracts architectural elements or building blocks in this domain, independent of technologies, protocols, etc. So you could probably ask what is the difference, and this is the level of abstraction, while the model describes the important concepts and relationship in the domain, focusing on what distinguishes the elements of the domain. The reference architecture elaborates further on the model to show more complete picture that includes showing what is involved in the realization of these modeled entities. Then we have the concrete architecture. This is the highest level of detailization that specifies the technologies, components, the relationships, in order to enable direct implementation. So I have put the definition here in one slide, so you can refer it later on. We have taken the formal definition of what a reference model is from the Web-Wide Services Consortium. Then the relevance of This model is, of course, to create some standards for concepts and relationships, also to break down the large problems into smaller chunks that could be easily understood, tackled, refined, so that developers can quickly learn the stuff and start focusing on dealing with their own problems. Of course, we need to improve the, and we want to improve the communication between people, create clear roles and responsibilities, and block persons of different things evaluating the solutions which is best for the particular business process. The reference model deals with concepts, so we are going to describe our concepts with concept maps. The key concepts are depicted in ovals, while the second layer concepts are rectangles. The most important ones are highlighted with bolded lines or text. And for easy traceability of the concept between the concept map and the layers, we are using different colors. So, starting with the first concept map, this is the concept map of the AAO domain. This is the root concept map, and you see, you know that in AAO domain, everything is about services that are to be delivered to end users to provide some added value. These end users are assisted persons, caregivers, etc. The services are realized or they take place in AAO spaces. And they are made up and they make use of some software and hardware components. The components are using the platform, AAO's platforms and the facilities there, which actually implement a reference architecture that defines the building blocks necessary for constructing the AAO space. So, the AAO space represents the logical boundaries between hardware, software, and human resources needed for provisioning of particular services. This is necessary in order to put separation between the old technology that is in the home or in the specific location and from the one that is to be used by the assisted persons in order to help him live and assist the daily life. So we can move to the next concept map, and this is the stakeholders. Stakeholders, these are entities, humans, organizations that are somehow involved and related to the domain problem. Of course, the key users are the end users, and the most important of them are the assisted persons. The stakeholders of the AAO domain have been previously introduced in one research project called Alliance. The reference is given in the bottom. And this diagram just depicts the results of the work of this project. So we have assisted person. Normally, people are talking about elderly people, but we are using this assisted person term in order to show that we are providing assistive technology, not only to elderly people, but also for people with some other problems. Then we have caregivers, informal caregivers. These are some relative friends, neighbors that are able to assist the persons in their daily life and represent them in some cases. All these are end users entity. We have also service providers. These are providing some components, software services, and part of these service providers are the developers of this service and the deployers, and also formal caregivers. These are doctors, care personnel that is educated and specially assigned with this responsibility. We have companies, industries that provide goods and services to the service providers, and we refer to them as platform stakeholders. So they include hardware developers, software developers that implement platforms, and the difference between service provider and platform stakeholder is that the provider developers, software developers, uses the software framework that is provided on the platform in order to develop and realize their own services, while the platform stakeholders are providing the hardware and software that defines that the platform. So we can move to the next concept map, and this is the concept map of the AL services. So everything in the AL reference architecture is about defining the services. So the AL service is a service, somebody that serves, provide some added value to somebody that is recipient, the beneficiary of this service. This is from a business point of view. The service is a combination of resources that are software resources, software components, hardware devices, people that are caregivers. We have also some applications that the end users can use and communicate through them with the system. And each AL service has own service lifecycle management model. This is the next concept map. Software developers and people involved in the development of the software are familiar with the process of provisioning the software and developing the software and the hardware components. Then in our AL domain, the service provider uses these components in order to compose an AL service and to offer it through some portal or somehow to the end user. We call this process publishing. Of course, retrieval of service from the public space is unpublishing on the service. The end user is able to acquire services that are published. This means that there is a process of getting in formal relationship with the service provider, in sometimes some legal relationship, signing a contract with some terms, service level agreement, payment, etc. Then the end user can receive the service. The service is deployed by special users called deployers. This includes installation of the software part onto the runtime platform, providing the hardware devices, connecting to the platform, teaching the end user how to deal with the system, if necessary, introducing human resources, care personnel, and also the deployer takes care of updating the service if necessary, not automated. In the presentation. Sorry. Get it? Okay. So then the end user is able to use the service. That is the service utilization concept. This is pretty similar to all software development process and providing some software. And this service lifecycle has a goal to support some business model. What we can say about the next concept map, this is the aerospace. The aerospace, as I said, is the defining the boundaries, legal, physical, functional boundaries of hardware and software that is assigned to specific end user, assisted person, or helping him achieving the his daily tasks. So what we have here is the AL service in the AL space provides some reasoning, and this is just a second. Using the information that is available in order to take some decisions, and in this case to realize the purpose of the service. So this could be in the area of context awareness. This describes the capability of aerospace to extract or modify information about the current state of the runtime environment, or personalization. This is the capability of the aerospace to handle with knowledge, characteristics, capabilities, preferences of each individual human user that is interacting with the system within the boundaries of the aerospace. Reactivity is, of course, the capability of the space to react on occurrence of certain situations. We have also proactivity. This is the capability of the space to perform actions that are anticipatory and aim to get prepared for future situations. Each AL space is described in service profile that defines the boundaries and defines the interaction and constraints. So we can go to the next slide. This is pretty familiar. The software and hardware components. These are artifacts. We say that they consist of artifacts that are executed within this AL space on the platform and devices, connected devices within the space. These artifacts are software components or the connected devices that communicate with each other and thus provide the execution of distributive services. We have the software components that enable the device to provide some functionality for communication, reasoning, executing actions, sensing, etc. The next is the AL platforms concept map. We have tried to demonstrate our interest on providing everything for the assisted person to end user by depicting the concept in a form shape of person with that, of course, they are platforms that can communicate with each other, share service functionalities. They implement the reference architecture and provide different tools that assist actors, stakeholders in specific areas, for example, development, publishing, visioning of the service, personalization, etc. The AO platform provides also the execution environment, what we call the middleware. This is where actually the software applications are executed, and it provides an abstraction from the hardware and operating system, also enable sharing the functionality between the platforms. The AO platforms also provide the basic services that enable the other services in communication and other areas. We have two types of services: platform-to-platform services. These are services developed by one service provider and used by another service provider of the platform. We have also platform-to-client services. These are services that are oriented to the end users, assisted persons, developers, and caregivers, etc. The last concept map that we have is the reference architecture concept map. Here we have the concepts for reference architecture, which focuses on the generic concepts, mechanisms, paradigms of ICT in order to solve some specific real-world AO domain issues. The reference architecture specifies abstract layers that define the basic building blocks in dealing with device abstractions, system connectivity, behavior and personalization of the system, interaction with the users and different modes to enable this, management of infrastructure, service lifecycle, etc. This abstract layer, of course, enable the distribution of the system, and the reference architecture also define the basic services that should be available on the platform. And I think this is very short, brief, quick overview of the reference model. Now you can take your time, ask questions to clarify if something has not been clear enough. So I see at the moment Christopher Meyer. Christopher, if you have any questions, you can go back to the slides and the specific contacts. Or for the learning, define the reference architecture with the three layers: model, reference architecture, and concrete architecture. So this is the very abstract and pretty high level abstraction of the architecture. The next webinar should be the reference architecture. There will be probably more clear, more specific, and there will be very good questions that are there. So, if there is no question, thank you for the question, and I will be back to the next one.
Thank you, Vanelline, for this nice presentation. I also think it's a good overview over the reference model. And you already mentioned, or Vanelline already mentioned, that the next webinar is going to be on the reference architecture. It's going to be a series of events, of webinars. So if you're interested in a specific part of Universal, you can go to the website, and I think we will manage to upload it next week or the week after that, so that all the webinars which are due to come are also available there, and you can look at it again and dive into the webinar which you really want. The next webinar is going to be on the website, announced on the website and on the social media streams. So please, if you're interested in that, please have a look at our website. We plan to do 2 to 3 webinars a month, so you can expect a lot more. Okay, any more questions? If not, then thank you, and you can always write us an email. The email addresses are on the slide. And I wish you a good rest of the week. Thank you, and bye.